And returning to our top story, Australian cricket legend and the greatest leg spinner of all time, Shane Warne, has been found dead in his Thai villa. Joining me live is Minister Bronnie Taylor, Minister for Women, Regional Health and Mental Health and Deputy Leader of the Nationals. Thank you so much for joining us, Minister. It's just so hard to comprehend and such a shock of Shane Warne, isn't it?
So hard to comprehend. He's been such a part of all of our lives on television and the incredible contribution he's made to sport. So it's a sad day for sport and it's a really sad day for Australia.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, condolences, of course, to his family and, of course, his children. Let's talk about the floods as well, as we've just been seeing with Claire and Danica and our reporters out and about. I mean, it's just devastating. We're seeing a once-in-a-1,000-year flood event for Lismore. The clean-up is massive. It's not only the clean-up, it's emotional, economical, then physical toll on everybody from a pandemic, and we've had, you know, numerous disasters, haven't we?
We really have. It's a tough, tough time for northern New South Wales, and what we really have to make sure is that, you know, during that clean-up that we're there on the ground, we're providing emotional support to people. We have to provide support for a clean-up. This will be a long-term, you know, process for everybody involved.
Absolutely. And also, Minister, in Parliament this week at a budget estimate hearing, Labor MP Greg Donnelly, he accused you of playing the gender card. Let's take a listen.
The only thing you've told us in regards to those LHDs is that with respect to future appointments to the board, you'll be a co-signatory. That's all we have found out from you this morning about what your role is going to be in regards to the Regional Health Minister.
Mr Donnelly, I would dispute that, and perhaps it's the way that you choose to listen and interpret that, but I would just point out to you that I am the fourth most senior minister in this government in New South Wales. I am the most senior woman in this government in New South Wales.
Got nothing to do
so
with
to
gender,
try
minister,
and patronise me in that way is it's, unacceptable.
No, Minister, don't play the gender card. It's got nothing to do with gender.
Chair.
I've indicated to you, Chair. you've had the morning to explain what essentially your role is, and you've utterly failed. That's what I'm saying.
I would ask you to withdraw that comment about me playing the gender card, Mr Chair. I would ask you to withdraw. Are you choosing not to withdraw that?
Minister, you raised it.
No, you did.
No, Minister, you put it on the table.
You said I was playing the gender card.
Because you put it on the table, Minister. You said you're the most senior female. You put that on the table.
And you said I was playing the gender card. I was simply stating the facts.
No, Minister, you put that on the table deliberately.
You asked him to withdraw the gender card. How do you feel about this?
Oh, look, just watching it back then, it just infuriates me. It was just appalling behaviour. This from the great Labor Party, the great supporter of women, who've got fantastic women in their party, to allow that sort of behaviour, that attitude to take place. I mean, they'd written the press statement and so they wanted to question me to get the answer. But the way that he did that, I think, is just so utterly disappointing. And, you know, as a member of parliament in the government, you expect a little bit more respect. And you know, he wouldn't do that to a bloke. And then all the blokes pile on. And I'm really grateful to the Greens MP, Cate Faehrmann. She came in and defended me, my own colleague, Wes Fanger. You know, it's just disgraceful. And I think it just makes me even more determined and more resolute to make sure that I call out such shocking and appalling behaviour.
Yes, and as we mentioned before, like, you did ask him to withdraw that comment. What do you think is going to happen going forward?
Look, he wouldn't withdraw it at the time. And he actually came back at the end when he was counselled by another colleague and then withdrew it. I mean, how pathetic. You know, at least if you're going to do something that's wrong and that's really disrespectful, have the guts to stand up and withdraw it. So, look, I hope he is taken to task, but I haven't heard anything. I haven't had an apology. I haven't heard from anyone else in the Labor Party about it. But, you know, I intend to keep calling this behaviour out because it's wrong and people do not deserve it.
And it's coming on the eve of International Women's Day on the 8th of March, which celebrates social, economic, cultural and political achievements for women.
That's right. Starting Women's Week and having to put up with that behaviour in Parliament from a male colleague is, pretty low blow.
Well, you handled it very well and thank you for coming on Sky News and sharing that with us. But very intense times and, yes, we look forward to hearing the outcome. But always great to see you, Minister Bronnie Taylor.
Thank you very much.
Take care.
Thanks for having me.